We're still looking for dark matter as some sort of fundamental particle. In order to probe dark matter, we can't just use conventional telescopes. We need to develop some kind of technology that's able to sense the particles, even though they are very, very, very weakly interacting. Here at Brown, we've had a team of undergraduates, graduates, postdocs, sort of working full-time on this for the last couple of years. The detector we've been working on here at Brown will allow us to dramatically improve our sensitivity when looking for these dark matter particles.
The tricky part about building a dark matter detector like we are, building the leading experiment in the world, is you have to push into regions where even the smallest things that you wouldn't normally care about become big problems. The air that we're breathing right now, you know, is filled with tiny little particles. All of that dust has natural radioactivity in it. And it's that natural radioactivity that could actually act as a major contaminant. So we have to build every single one of the components that we have in very, very rigorously controlled spaces, because otherwise it could actually create signals that are difficult to distinguish from dark matter itself.
The final assembly itself, the sort of unification of all these separate parts, is going to take place at the underground lab, at Sanford Lab, which is in South Dakota.
Where it will be delivered to our experiment and installed at the bottom of our TPC within the next coming months.
We know a lot about conventional matter, but conventional matter is a tiny less than 5% of the total composition of the universe. One of the sort of extraordinary aspects, for instance, of a graduate student who's doing research in a team like mine is, of course, they have to become the world's leading expert in their area of research, and that's just what they've done. You have students that are, you know, early 20s, and they do know more about this aspect of a particle physics experiment than anybody else. It's the only way you can actually get a world-leading experiment, is every person that is working directly on it knows more than anybody else in the world, you know, about the subject. That's how you get it right.
The thing about physics is you never really know exactly what these discoveries could result in. We just do it because we're interested, because we want to know, and because there's plenty of stuff out there, and I don't think we'll ever really reach the bottom of it, but we have to keep trying.